The lasers on your 112 will eventually need realign, just simply due to the vibration of the head carriage moving up and down the V-track for hours at a time. Here are a couple key factors that will determine whether or not you will need to realign your lasers. One, you are seeing a double line where the lasers are being projected onto the weld track. Two, you are noticing changes in the width of your weld along the length of your weld seam. You're going to need the following items in order to realign your lasers. One, 2-inch masking tape. Two, a fine tip permanent marker. Three, a 1-inch silicone weld roller. Four, a 3/16 Allen wrench. Five, a ladder or a step stool. Take the 2-inch masking tape and tear off strips about as wide as your weld track and place them across the weld track about 12 inches apart. You will need to place them from the beginning of the weld track to the end of the weld track. After you are done placing the strips of masking tape down the entire length of the track, you will need to make sure that your 1-inch weld roller is installed and in the correct position on the Teflon tape covering the weld track. Now, the placement of the weld roller can vary depending on the product and the operator preference. After you install your weld roller in the desired position, you want to grab a fine tip permanent marker. You will then jog the head carriage with the weld roller in the down position and place the weld roller on top of each strip of masking tape. While the weld roller is on top of each strip, you will need to trace a line onto the masking tape using the inside and outside edge of the weld roller. This will show you where the weld roller is tracking on the weld track. After each line is marked, you will then need to grab your 3/16 Allen wrench and a ladder and or step stool. There are two bolts that are located on the top and side of the laser mounts. You will use your 3/16 Allen wrench and slightly loosen the bolts on the top and side of your laser mounts. You'll want to adjust the laser lines so that they line up on top of the marks made on the strip of masking tape. You will need to repeat this process down the entire length of the machine until there are no double lines and all the laser lines match up on the top of the marks made on each strip of masking tape. After the lasers are aligned and straight on the weld track, you can now bring the head carriage back to the home position and take off the strips of masking tape. You'll want to then run a test weld to confirm that your welds are straight and 1 inch in width.
If issues are still occurring, please visit our website at www.weldmaster.com or call into our office at 330-833-6739. For any additional support or to schedule a service visit with one of our highly qualified service technicians. Again, thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you for choosing Miller Weldmaster for all of your welding needs.